Now, first, so before going to the modes, four modes of operation. So we are going to discuss about the four modes of gun diode. What are all the four modes we are going to discuss? Okay. So before going to discuss about the four modes, where initially we have some domain formation, a concept we have a domain formation. Domain formation. So we'll see what is this domain formation, why the concept has been introduced in this modes. Okay. So domain formation is nothing but we have seen in case of EDC&D. Okay. You might be noticed that because of improper doping, the charge carriers are not uniformly distributed in the device. Either you take a silicon or germanium. In case of EDC, we have seen that while doping, what happens? So the adding of impurities has been not uniform. Okay. So because of improper doping, the electrons which is been spreading in the device will not be of uniformly distributed. Okay. The electrons are whatever the charge carriers are not uniformly distributed. So thereby it is accumulated maximum at one area and minimum at other area within the device, where the accumulation of charge carriers will be maximum at one side and less at another side. This is because of improper doping. Similarly, in the case of gun diode, as I have told, the compound semiconductor gallium arsenide, that is of N-type gallium arsenide, it has been taken out. And because of this, what happens? Because of improper doping, a current pulse, we can say that a domain, a pulse which is being generated, a formation of domain, we can see a domain is being formed within the device because of improper doping. Okay. So this formation of domain is being called as domain formation. It is being resulted because of improper doping of the device, and such type of accumulation of charges at one place, and that has been maximum, and that is being called as domain formation. So they may ask 2 marks or 3 marks question, you need to explain this. And okay, what is the domain formation in gun diode? And this is been the advantage the people who are attending the classwork. Okay, so now when the domain is being formed, then it is been from it will be moved, it is been not stayed within the device for a longer time. So it is been of cathode and it is been of anode, where the domain will be keep on moving from cathode to anode. Okay. And because of this movement, the gun diode will be operating in four different modes. Okay. The gun diode will be operating in four modes as the domain is being keep on moving from one side of the device to another side. So let me give it what are those four modes of operation. One is transit time domain mode. First one is transit time domain mode. It can also be called as gun mode. It can also be called as gun mode. Okay. And the second one, it is being called as delayed domain mode. Delayed domain mode, second mode of operation of the gun diode. Okay. So, and third one, we can call it as quenched domain mode. Third one is being called as quenched domain mode. And fourth one, it is being called as last one, limited space charge. Limited space charge accumulation mode. Accumulation mode. So these are the four modes on which the gun diode will be operated. I'll be explaining what are the features of these four modes. By this, we'll be finishing the gun diode. Okay, within just 5 to 10 minutes, I can do it. Can be done. So that domain formation based upon the formation of the domain, and as it tends to move from one part of the device to another part, that gun diode will be shifting its mode from one to other. Okay. So let me proceed with all the domain concepts or working functionality of these four modes in which the gun diode has been operating. Let me carry down the first mode, okay, first domain mode. The first mode, it has been said to be as transit time mode. Transit time domain mode. Transit time domain mode. I don't want to give a theoretical concept. I want to give what are the important points related to the delayed domain mode. So for that, I am going to explain the diagrams also in which each and every mode it is being done. Okay. So this is the normal characteristics which we have. So normal characteristics, it is being done as the gun diode characteristics it is being given. We know that so this is the gun diode characteristics where it is being taken as the different cases, lower valley and upper valley. So that is enough valley current and the threshold current ITH or maximum current. Okay. So where now it is being taken as, you've been taken as a current or a voltage, we can say here based upon this. Now here we are applying the electric field. Here electric field and here it is being taken as a voltage. Okay, the graph which is being performed here now, the voltage and the electric field which is being applied. So this is the normal characteristics we have. Now let me draw a diagram of the gun diode when it is being operating in transit time domain mode. So for the case of transit time domain mode, the graph which is being related. So this is the graph which is being related. I'll be showing it out. And this is the normal standard waveform, which has been the electric field which has been applied. Okay. And this has been the threshold electric field which has been applied. As I've said, the electrons will be keep on moving from valley, lower valley to the upper valley. Basically, the threshold value and the maximum value ES, it has been applied. Okay. So in this case, it is enough voltage where it has been the transit time. This is nothing but the transit time. T, suffix T is a transit time. Now, in this case, the when it can be said that the gun diode has been operating in transit time mode. And in this case, the we have a general expression to calculate the frequency, where the frequency is being given as it is the ratio of VD, the drift velocity to the length of the device. Okay. So the frequency is being given as the drift velocity, velocity to the distance is nothing but the frequency. Now, the operation of the gun diode at, in transit time domain mode, it can be done where the velocity which is being applied, F into L is nothing but the velocity. The velocity which is being applied for the gun diode for the transit time domain mode is being given as 10 to the power of centimeters per second. This is the amount of velocity which is being applied to the gun diode when operating in transit time domain mode. So during which ways it has been observed that the transit time T naught will be almost equal to the oscillating time period will be equal to the transit time mode. And during this, what happens? The gun diode is said to be operating in transit time domain mode, and where the efficiency for this has been of just 10%. And because the domain which is being arrived at the anode will be at the lower current level. Okay. The domain which is being formed initially in this particular mode, which has been of lower level. Okay. So that efficiency has been very less. Okay. That has been only 10%. Okay. So this is the graph and this is the properties of the gun diode when operating in transit time domain mode. And second case, the delayed domain mode. You have to remember this particular graph and the respective characteristics values. Delayed domain mode is the second one. When the gun diode is being operating in delayed domain mode, we can say that there is a small differences over here in the diagram where, and we have one more point which is to be remembered. It does not depend upon any external circuits. No external circuits are required. to operate the GUN diode in this mode. And the operating frequency will be less than 30 gigahertz. Please, you can have a photocopy. I'll be sending the material also. And by today or tomorrow, I'll be sending this material. And second case, delayed domain mode, where the graph, it has been depending upon the transit time, where it has been found that this is then a transit time here. And it is the basic diagram in which the DC bias, the threshold electric field, which has been applied. And this is the voltage normally, where the domain is being delayed or it has been going to stay for longer amount of time within the device. Okay, so that the field which has been applied will passing greater than the transit time. Okay, and it is being given as normally the threshold value ETH and then a saturation value of ES. Okay, and this is the graph related to the delayed domain mode when the GUN diode has been operated. And why it is been moving out? Because the velocity applied to this device during the delayed domain mode, it is being given as 10 to the power of 6 centimeters per second to 10 to the power of 7 centimeters per second. Between this, the velocity has been applied to the GUN diode. Then it will be starting operating in delayed domain mode. It starts operating in delayed domain mode. And during which it has been found that the field which has been applied will be less than the threshold field. The field applied will be less than the threshold field over here. Okay. And because of that, the time period, you can see that the time period of T naught, it has been taking the time period T naught here more than the transit time. So T naught will be greater than the transit time device. Okay. Transit time. And as the domain has been as taking a longer time to travel from cathode to anode, so it won't allow to form another domain as it until the movement of this domain from cathode to anode, this will be keep on moving out within the device. Until that, it won't allow to form another domain. Okay. And because of that, the efficiency where it is being due to the formation of this, the efficiency of this particular delayed domain mode is being given as 20%, and the frequency of this is been less than or equal to 30 gigahertz. Okay. If you could be able to remember these performance characteristics, you can write the word statements on yourself and you can explain. And last two types of modes. Okay. Third mode, we can say that quenched domain mode. Quenched domain mode. And in this case, the diagram you can see here, the diagram which is being obtained, it is being somewhat where the time taken will be a little bit less than the transit time. Okay, so this is the normal time period T naught, and here the time taken here, it is being of E threshold value and ES value here. And it is being found that it is being taking less amount of time here. See. So within a short moment only, the transit time here T naught is being very much less than the transit time TT. Okay. And when the GUN diode is been operating with such a graph, then it has been said to be in quenched domain mode. It has been operating in quenched domain mode. For that, the drift velocity which is being applied is being given as it will be greater than 2 into 10 to the power of 7. Centimeters per second. It's been greater than the previous two cases. And because of that, what happens? The domain totally gets disappeared because of high velocity it has been applied. The domain itself has been clearly totally disappeared. Okay. So due to which, what happens? The operating frequency as it has been improved, where it can use greater than 30 gigahertz. In this case, the GUN diode, as the velocity has been applied, has been very high, and the transit time T naught will be very much less than the transit time. Due to this, the frequency has been increased. Okay, the frequency has been increased as the domain has been not totally formed. But the major disadvantage of this is it depends upon the external circuit. It depends upon the external circuit, because of which the efficiency has been dropped to 13%. The efficiency is being dropped to 13%. And the last one that is being called as limited space charge, limited space charge accumulation mode. The Gunn diode is said to be operating in the last mode. The graph related to this is being given as, you need to work out on the graph, Andy. It's been very easy, just once if you understand this. And here it has been clearly stated that the diode, the Gunn diode is being operating with a multiple pulses over here. It has been operated with multiple pulses. And this is because the velocity in this case also, it has been applied more than 2 into 10 to the power of centimeters per second. Okay. And where this is the most important mode of operation. Okay. As it has been having a high power and high efficiency. Then in this mode, formation of domain is enough disadvantage only. This mode itself, it won't allow to form the domain itself. Okay. So formation of domain has been disadvantaged because of improper doping. But the Gunn diode, whenever it has been operating in limited space charge accumulation mode, there is, it won't allow to form the domain itself. Okay. So that is the biggest advantage we have in this case. So that the efficiency, it has been improved to 13% to 20%. It has been improved here. Okay. And the main frequency, it can be able to operate up to 100 gigahertz only. The frequency of operation is being up to 100 gigahertz. The main disadvantage is that it depends upon completely on external circuits. For switching off something like that, it depends upon the external circuits. The major disadvantage of this Gunn diode when operating in limited space charge accumulation mode. Okay. So these are all the four modes of operation and it's the normal characteristics. The first mode, second mode, third mode, and fourth mode. So for that, you need to remember all the points, whatever I have written over here. So this is all about the Gunn diode. In the afternoon class, I'm going to discuss about the avalanche transit time devices. So by that, we'll be finishing this, the first half part. And please make sure that to attend even that class also, because it's been very important topics. These two are very important topics. Why the strength? It has been increased in the second half only. Okay, fine. Okay, I'm winding up.